As a child, you would wait and watch from far away. But you always knew that you'd be the one that work while they all play. And you'd lay awake at night and scheme.
Thank you. It's more than just a game. It's everything. What is your why? Why do you play this game? Why do you love this game? Why will you fight and die for this game? Is it for the championship? Is it for your teammates? Is it for your coaches? Is it for those fans who back you day after day? You are prepared for this game. You know what the other team is doing. You know the game plan. We put the hard work in all year. Now it's time to grind. Now it's time to shine. When you're walking down that tunnel, if you're not going out there to win, don't go out there. You've been waiting your entire life for this moment. And now that it's here, let's show the world we are prepared. We are prepared for war. We are prepared for battle. We are prepared for the enemy on the other side of the field. It doesn't matter who we face. We will fight. We will grind. We will dominate. And we will win. We will win this championship. You've been working. You've been working. And you've been working to defeat them, to destroy them. So don't show any weakness. Don't show any pain. Don't even feel any pain. Now is the time to let them know we will be victors. No one will get in the way of this victory. Brothers, together, I'll fight for you. You fight for me. Together we fight to win. I'm looking for someone that would dare try to stop me. No one can stop me. No one can stop my team. No team will stop us if we stand together. All the hard work we put in will show on the field. The field of battle. Let's go win this championship.
Welcome back to the playoffs, the best time of year.
Here we go. Yeah, it's going down like that, son. You think you're the best?
I think this crowd is ready for hockey. Sit back and enjoy this one.
You're looking at it. The best of the best. Best there is. Enjoy the show.
Let's get ready to rumble in the jungle. Got the ball to the
pocket. Shoots, he scores. And Aaron scores.
Man, oh man. Austin Matthews spins out one. Along the goal line and the in.
That was awesome.
McDavid to Draisaitl. Scores. Will the Yossi back get in? Mark Messer goes down. Oh my goodness gracious.
What is worth my word is burned.
Shining. You never won a trophy until you won this, and I don't know how to describe it.
I'm so numb right now, I don't know what to say.
When you were a kid, is it like what you dreamed of?
My greatest moment in the history.
We all have dreams. Fantastic moments. And milestones that live only in our minds. But dreams don't become reality all on their own. They must be shaken awake.
For the Stanley Cup, I think you risk everything.
This is what it takes to win the Stanley Cup.
12 stitches in the head.
Tirelessly.
Probably the most emotionally and physically draining thing I've ever been a part of.
For years. For a lifetime.
We have too many guys that have sacrificed their whole career, and this is the time.
I appreciate it a heck of a lot more when it takes you 16 years.
22 years. You did it.
Drenched in sweat. in tears.
You gotta go through some of this to win.
Those are the horrible moments. Those are the bad times. It's all worth it now. God damn it, it's all worth it.
And even the greatest ones knew that forging silver from ice can't be done alone.
The temperature has reached a boiling point.
He scores!
These guys are dream makers, one and all.
Tonight, hope and awe fill the air.
Two of the best teams in the NHL.
This is going to be a great series.
Breathe. Listen. React.
Mika's a Vanagon! This place is on its feet!
They do a good job cheering their team on, but we don't care.
Nature's all alone, and he scores!
Playoffs for me is completely game to game to game. We're gonna have to elevate.
One team will come closer to the dream.
Welcome, everyone, to the Verizon pregame on a gorgeous day in New York City where the temperature climbed to 80 degrees today. Tonight inside Madison Square Garden, game two between the Carolina Hurricanes and the New York Rangers. It's the Rangers who took one step closer to the dream in game one with a 4-3 win. They're now 5-0 in this postseason. 5-0 in the playoffs for just the third time in franchise history. The Hurricanes lost the special teams battle in game one. Turning that around is a key for Carolina tonight. Good evening, everybody, and welcome. I'm Sean McDonough upstairs. Ray Ferraro between the benches. Delighted to have you with us. Ray, when we came on the air Sunday before game one, we talked about these two teams as the two best in the regular season on special teams. Well, in game one, the Rangers won that part of the game. They were 2-for-2 on the power play. Carolina 0-for-5.
It really became the difference in what, as we expect, will be a very tightly contested series. Just 3 points separate the two teams in the regular season. There wasn't much to separate them in the first game. A three-goal first period for the Rangers, helped by a couple of penalties from the Carolina Hurricanes. D'Angelo took one in the neutral zone. 9 seconds later, Zibanejad, after some passing wizardry, is on the board. Then Kuznetsov takes an undisciplined penalty in the offensive zone. He won't play in game two. It took the Rangers a little longer this time, but Vinny Trocheck was able to score. The Rangers' power play is 8 for their last 16. They're a devastating power play. When they play well at even strength, those special teams carry them. Their penalty killing was perfect, and Carolina didn't get anything going.
Another thing the Canes talked about before the game tonight is getting more pucks through to the net. They average more than 33 shots on goal in the regular season. Just 25 on Shesterkin in game one. Rangers doing a great job in the first game blocking shots.
Well, the Canes want to shoot the puck. They want to create chaos off the shot, the rebound, the block shot, whatever it is. But the Rangers were just in the right place most of the time. They blocked almost 30 shots in game one. And the Canes want to get the puck to the net even more in game two. Well, they're going to have to move their bodies around the shooting blocks of the Rangers, who are in perfect position. But they will say, the Canes, that they did hit two goal posts on the power play. And so what was a 4-3 game really was just by the thinnest of margins. We expect this to be close. Game one was close. Game two will be too.
Igor Shesterkin back in net for New York. 28 straight playoff games now, allowing 3 goals or fewer. At the other end, Frederik Andersen's been off his game a bit lately. He's given up 3 or more in the last 3 after doing that only 3 times in 16 regular season games.
Standing up, ladies and gentlemen, the highest award in the world's fastest game is like no other feeling in sports.
This is the place where Stanley Cup dreams come true.
ABC is home to the Stanley Cup Final.
Darko.
They score! Mika Zibanejad hammers one home.
Zibanejad!
Sebastian Aho. This place is pandemonium.
Game two, ready to go in the second round series in the Eastern Conference. You're watching the Stanley Cup playoffs on ESPN, presented by Geico. MSG rocking as usual, sellout crowd, more than 18,000 on hand. Rangers have taken care of home ice this year. 30 home ice wins in the regular season, the franchise record. And they've won 12 of their last 15 in the postseason here at MSG. We're ready for the national anthem. Let's join public address announcer Joe Tomlinson.
If able, we ask that you please rise and remove your hats for the national anthem. Tonight's colors are presented by the New York Police Department. And here to sing the Star-Spangled Banner, please welcome back Grammy Award-winning baritone, John Brancy.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, all the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the lucky tugger of a thirsty nail gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say,
Carolina will need to find a way to win on the road. 4-12 in their last 16 playoff games away from Raleigh. They have the great Dane Frederik Andersen in net again tonight, the 34-year-old from Denmark. 4-2 in this postseason, has started every game. They won round one against the New York Islanders in five. The four goals allowed in game one, the most he's given up this postseason. One of them a soft goal scored by Artemi Panarin that proved to be the difference. At the other end, Igor Shesterkin remains perfect. 5-0 in this postseason and trying to extend that streak to 29 straight playoff games, having allowed three goals or fewer. Eric Furlan and Kelly Sutherland to the referees. Johnny Murray and Shandor Alfonso, the linesman. It'll be Mika Zibanejad and Jordan Staal to take the opening faceoff. Zibanejad, the offensive star of game one, with two goals and an assist in the first period. Carolina won the faceoff, and here's Ryan Lindgren, who opens on defense with Adam Fox.
The Rangers take it along the wall. dished on over to Slavin. And he slides it quickly to Burns. He takes a moment to backtrack but maintains possession.
Oh, he just got thunderstruck!
Well, he did. I mean, closing so quickly, no time and space there, and just crushes him.
What a hit. And he denied that opportunity.
In order to dictate the tempo of the game right at the onset of it, you want to make your opponent think and hear you coming, and that's what he does with that first hit.
Moves it to Fox. Slick feed. The Hurricanes get a hold of the puck in their own end. Carolina's in on the offensive attack now. Centering feed, and he denies that great opportunity there. Steps inside the attacking zone down the left wing. Stopped by the goaltender. Makes the save again.
What a great job of tracking the puck. Not one, but two consecutive saves.
More than half the period left to play. We've still got zeros on the board. Heedle's won the faceoff, and now let's see what they can do. Oh, I thought he was going to be beaten, and he somehow got a piece of that. Takes the shot, and he says no. And we get a whistle as the goaltender decides to hang on to this one.
Miller's been showing some frustration. You know, when you want to contribute as an athlete, especially when you have a strong skill set, and then you're in a pointless streak, man, the frustration grows, and it builds, and you start to squeeze the stick tight.
The Rangers gain control of the puck. Quick stop by Anderson. Taken along the wall by Orlov. And he's taken down. The officials are signaling for a penalty. Let's get the call here. The Rangers are going to be shorthanded, tripping the call.
Keep up and make the stop, guys.
Trocheck's won the draw here in the defensive zone. And they send it right back to him. Coming to the slot! Big time save by Anderson.
A timely save is everything to your team, and this goaltender, he bails his team out.
Quick feed to Kuznetsov. And a solid save there as we play on.
What a fantastic save from a high-danger scoring area, James. And, I mean, he's bailing his team out. They have to do a better job of protecting the middle of the ice.
Svechnikov's relied upon to generate chances for his team. Panarin's got that third-eye zone ability, which means he's fantastic at making those difficult passes to create the perfect chance for his teammates. Let's see if one of these stars can give their team the upper hand in this matchup. Back to you now.
Carolina's got a hold of the puck. Takes a shot. Oh, I thought that was the icebreaker, but he missed the net.
Well, yeah, and that would have been the game's first goal. They did a great job of working to position, getting the opportunity. You got to find a way to at least hit the net.
He was totally locked in on that play. Takes the feed. And he takes the feed. Knocks the puck down with a stick. Takes the feed from the wing. Great defensive effort with the stick. Gets the puck over to Teravainen. And he'll take a moment to regroup back at center. Moves it to the middle. Great defensive play to pick off the pass. Moves it to the middle. The Rangers get a hold of the puck along the boards. Let's see what the officials are calling.
Well, the official is right there to make the call, and no question about it, it's tripping. Anytime you take someone's feet out from under them, you're going to head to the box for two.
Fox has got that zone ability that helps him generate scoring, guys. With no ice available on the power play, let's see if he can get a good look here.
Carolina's got possession here in their own end. Trying to get it down the ice. Pulled over to the ice and loses the puck. Tries to the crease, and the shot dies in the traffic jam. Here's a chance.
Oh, a spectacular save right there.
save, James. Well, that's a tough penalty to take at the end of a period, and it's all about the PK unit now. They've got to kill the time off, get to the intermission where they can reset.
They'll play some 4-on-4.
4-on-4, you want to utilize north, south, east, west, and capitalize on the speed with the extra ice available. You can bet your coaching staff is going to put some pretty quick players out there.
Off target!
Coaches often measure scoring chances, and he does a real good job to get to that spot, but he will be disappointed. It's so difficult to get to, you want to convert when you get there.
Handles the pass. Good sweat on after this first period. We've got lots more in store, and we're coming back with a clean sheet of ice next. Opening faceoff here in this second period is about set to go. The Hurricanes win the opening possession here, and they still got some time left on this power play. Scores on the man advantage, and put one home.
And this is exactly why you spend so much time in practice working on specialty teams, James. You can see that good movement to open up lanes, just disrupt the box there, and they're able to cash it in. Man, that looked like a goal scorer's goal. Just a knack for the net, but it all comes off of a beautiful distribution. I mean, just eyes in the back of the head to be able to give that gift right to the stick.
The Hurricanes, through their hard work and tenacity, have taken a one-goal lead here in the second.
It's certainly better to play with the lead, James, but you know that there's a lot of one-way left, and your opponent is going to come pushing and pressing. This game has been tight all the way around, and I expect that it will continue to be.
The Rangers gain possession in their own end. Wheeler's got it into offensive territory. Being stopped by the goaltender right in front.
I love this save, James. I mean, the goaltender is so aggressive on this play. Doesn't give the shooter any time to get rid of it.
Carolina's got the puck in their own end. Laying the body. Poked away by Miller. New York's got the puck in the defensive end. There's the physical side. Carolina's got possession of the puck. Gun reach for the stick to knock the puck away. Moves it quickly over to Teravainen. Tripped up on the play, and the referees caught that one. Here comes the call.
Such a tough penalty to take when the game's within reach. They're looking for the equalizer, and now they find themselves shorthanded.
Generate some scoring here, guys. The power play is a great opportunity for him to use his skills to his team's advantage.
Grabbed along the board by Schneider. Roslovic's got it in the defensive end. Pokes the puck away. Here they come on the attack. Quick pass to Gensel. Comes up with a glove save.
Well, he's showing great mobility here as he drops into the butterfly and moves across his crease with ease to make the save.
Here's a shot and makes the save. Heedles recognizing they're still shorthanded here as they get ready for the faceoff. The Hurricanes win the draw. And he takes the dish. Svechnikov's got it in the offensive zone. Stopped by the goaltender. Takes the pass from his goaltender. The Rangers move to the offensive zone. Moves it to the middle. And he shuts down a great scoring chance there. And he comes up big again. They score!
Shows the critical nature of specialty teams with up by two and you give up a shorty, that's tough. The coach ain't gonna like it at all.
We haven't even hit the midway mark of the period. You can feel the energy in this crowd. It's a tie game. Carolina's power play is over. What a disaster as they give up a shorthanded goal.
The question here, James, is what are you gonna do next? You gave up a shorty, you gotta find a way to get back in the game. What I mean by that is you have to reset, not just physically, but emotionally and mentally, and get back on track. Timely saves as well. A lot of shots that he's faced, and the save percentage is an indicator of it.
The Hurricane snap. Oh, save!
That doesn't swing momentum in your favor. I don't know what will, James. That's a last-ditch effort to make a play. What a beautiful save.
I love this. These fans are starting to get on their feet to recognize what an incredible save we just witnessed.
Yeah, he made an incredible one, didn't he? And you got to embrace it when they're on their feet and support of you, because you know you hear boos often when you let a bad one in. So embrace it. You can tell that he's feeling it right now.
Burns carries the puck in his own zone. Gustafson's got it across the line. New York's got the puck against the wall. The Rangers ready to go on the attack. Snapper from the slot. Big save.
This is an impressive save right here, James. I mean, there's a ton of net front presence, and so a lot of traffic that he has to battle through to find the puck, and he does, and he makes a nice save.
Here's a shot. What the stop. Slides it diagonally to Jarvis. And he can't hang on after that hit. And he takes the pass. And he slides it quickly to Panarin. Look out, here they come on the attack. Scores! The go-ahead goal puts them in front.
Well, and this has been trending to happen, James. They've been closing on the puck quickly since an upward trajectory as his game's progressed and they find the back of the net. I love the way they were able to execute on this odd man rush, James. Really used the ice to their advantage, manipulating their opponent, the ice that they did have. And then they were able to capitalize when the shot came their way.
The Rangers pick up the all-important go-ahead goal late here in period number two.
Well, you're always cutting periods into five-minute increments, and this is the one that they wanted to score in, James, because it creates momentum, momentum that they can carry forward to the intermission.
Here's a short pass to Zibanejad. Takes a shot. Just gets a piece of it to keep it out wide. Tries to get it to Lundgren. There's the horn. 40 minutes in the books. We'll get a refresh for both the players. Ice. Back with a third period next. This penalty. They put the puck into the offensive end. New York's got it in their own zone. Gustafson's got it along the wing. And it goes off the stick and off to the side. And play rolls on as he came up with a nice stop there. as that goes right out of the zone. Puck scooped up by Kako. Moves it to the middle. And that's stopped. And pokes the puck loose inside the offensive end. They'll want to clear the zone here while they're trying to kill off this penalty.
Karabinen's almost ready to get back on the ice.
Both sides back to even strength.
It's amazing how a kill can put your opponent on their heels because they had an opportunity on the offensive side of the puck. At a critical time of the game, when the game is still within reach, massive kill.
Moves it to the middle. And the puck is frozen. We'll get a stoppage in play here. The Rangers have looked good tonight, especially offensively here in this third period. Aho's won it off the faceoff. Passes it to Karabinen. And now he tries to get it across to Svechnikov. Makes the move in front. Spectacular stop by the goaltender. How did he hang on to that?
That's a great save as he drops into the butterfly. You want to make sure that you take away the top of the net, but you know you got the lower net covered, and the agility to be able to move across the crease is an example right there.
The Hurricanes played along the wing. New York's looking to break out of their own end. A chance in front, and that doesn't connect. And a good smack with the stick to get it down. Oh, save on the play! Wow!
Oh, that's grand larceny, James. I mean, he just stole one away from his opponent. What a save.
New York's gained possession along the boards. I don't think anybody was handing onto the puck after that hit. Blocked in traffic. The Rangers will play it in their own end. Centering feed. Oh, he comes up with a stop. Quick feed down low. And he loses control of the puck. Scooped up along the wall by Trocheck.
Oh, he's saved it. Oh, my goodness, what a stop.
Oh, that's unbelievable, James. I have no idea how he got to that puck. It's some gymnastics at its finest. Impressive save, James, and love to look at these ones again because it's not just being in great position, it's being desperate, it's finding a way to get to the puck, keeping your eye on it at all times, tracking it, out-battling and out-willing everyone around you.
New York's looking to close things out here late in this third period as they continue to lead. Play resumes as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. The Hurricanes have it now.
Been a low-scoring affair, James, but it's been entertaining on both sides, just unable to finish. And as an athlete, this can be very frustrating. You're squeezing the stick tighter and tighter with every miss.
The Rangers are on the attack. Anderson's got it, and the officials blow the play dead.
Well, and this is a smart play. He's been dialed in all night and recognizes that he doesn't want his team to make any mistakes. The safe play sometimes is to hold on.
Here in the late goings of the period, the Rangers are clinging to a 2-1 lead. Lumps the puck into the corner of the offensive zone. Almost down to the final minute here in this third. Moves it to Hedo. And a stick in the lane deflects that one away. Oh, and he whiffs. Puck picked up by Aho. Quick pass to Shea. Svechnikov's moving it ahead. Moves the pass in front. Picked off in front. The Hurricanes have pulled the goaltender here. They've got the extra. Scores into the empty net.
This was right in my wheelhouse, James. These were the type of moments that I played in, and everyone can take a breath now that the insurance marker has hit the 4x6. On the dying moments of the game, they get the empty netter, James, and that's just a result of having urgency, making sure they protect the middle of the ice, and hey, they get it down the ice and get the empty netter to boot.
The Rangers' persistence pays off as they get the empty netter, and that should probably do it here for this one, Cheryl.
Yeah, that should be the insurance marker, James. They've got a comfortable lead now. They can all breathe a little bit lighter, and that should finish it off.
Oh, at the buzzer, a big save! The Rangers have been the busier team in the shot department, and they lead it late in this third period. There's the final horn, and that'll do it here this evening.
tale of two hockey teams right now, Cheryl. At one end of the ice, this is a team that has elevated their game into the postseason, and another that just doesn't seem ready for prime time right now.
Well, and you got to give a lot of credit to the team that's up by two, right? I mean, they've got a two-game series lead here, and it's all because of the way they've played. They've really put their opponent on their heels. Now they can get a three-game lead. I mean, you know, this is almost as good as over.
The playoffs are a war of attrition, and we know that they will continue, and we will see you then at the next broadcast. For Cheryl Pounder, I'm James Cebulski. We'll talk to you then.